there, and welcome to What Is It Wednesday? Today's question covers section A07 of the 4th edition task list and C6 of the 5th edition task list. And today's question is, this derivative measure can be used to compare two or more procedures. And the answer is trials to criterion. So derivative measures are measures that are derived from the dimensional quantities. And there are two types of derivative measures. There's percentage and, of course, today's answer, trials to criterion, which is considered an occurrence measurement. This trials to criterion measure gives us the number of response opportunities that are required to achieve a pre-specified level of performance criteria. And a trial within the trial to criterion has three things, or is defined by three things. The first is the nature of the target behavior. The second is the relevant variables and antecedents. And the third being a predetermined performance criteria, the number of opportunities to emit the behavior independently. Now, this derivative measure is used for a couple of things. First of all, evaluating mastery over a class of concepts, like colors, blue versus green, man versus woman, comparing two or more procedures is something we can use trials to criterion for. And finally, skills like making a sandwich can be measured through trials to criterion. This type of measure can be measured as count, rate, duration, and latency. So in the example of teaching a client how to make a sandwich, what trials to criterion would tell us is exactly how many trials it took for the client to learn how to make that sandwich independently. I hope that helps, and I'll see you guys next time.